Hey there. Kind of cold to be outside without a coat. Excuse me, are you all right? Erica, what?
Erica, what are you doing outside in this cold weather? Come on, you put this over your shoulders now. There you go.
Hold that.
Oh my God, your hands are absolutely frozen. Give me your hands. Let me put these gloves on your hands. Come on, now what?
Thank you.
What's wrong? Huh? What are you doing out here all alone? There you go.
I've just been driving around all night. I've been trying to make some sense of all this. Bianca.
Yeah. What about Bianca?
She's lost me, Dimitri. I have lost my little girl.
Come, sit over here with me. Now, you're saying Bianca is lost to you. Did she go back to Seattle?
No.
Well, she's not sick, is she?
Yes, in a way she is. She's come under someone's influence. And she's convinced herself that she, I haven't said it out loud. Bianca thinks that she's gay.
Wow. I see. That's a lot for you to take in. You know, she isn't sick. I mean, that's, thank God she didn't have a relapse.
No. But Dimitri, I mean, if she continues with this belief, I mean, her life could be ruined. You know how intolerant people are.
Yeah, but you've got gay friends working in the fashion industry.
I know. Yes, I know. And I've supported gay rights, but it's very different when it's your own child.
Yeah, I understand how it can be so upset. No parent wants their child to suffer in any way.
That's right. Oh, and it kills me to see her suffering, and she is suffering. But she's not the only one, Dimitri. I feel so betrayed, and I know I shouldn't, but I do, and it just makes things harder.
For you?
Yes, for me, but also for Bianca. I mean, Dimitri, if she keeps on insisting that she's, that this is how she is, I mean, her whole life could be so difficult. It could be in danger. I mean, you know how people are. They should be subject to ridicule. I mean, people have been killed for this, Dimitri.
Yeah.
She's only 16. I mean, when I was her age, I didn't even know who I was or what I really wanted out of life.
Well, no. I don't think that's true. I think that you knew from the cradle that you wanted to be a star. Well, why don't you let Bianca know what she needs to be for herself?
It's different. Dimitri, this is her sexuality, and she's been ill.
Well, yeah, but...
Dimitri, this is not about careers. I mean, how could my beautiful little girl get so confused? And what could have caused this?
Well, it's not an issue to blame yourself for.
Well, I know who did it. It was that horrible girl from rehab. She did it to Bianca. She warped her thinking. She enlisted her. And if anyone laid the groundwork for this, it was Barbara. Because Barbara had the biggest influence on Bianca during her most formative years. And so, if anyone's to blame for turning my innocent, sweet little girl into someone who thinks that she's gay, it's Barbara.
At the risk of you lopping off my head, I was under the impression that Barbara was good to Bianca.
No, she was not. She was not good to Bianca. That was all an act. Behind closed doors, she made Bianca feel like an unwanted stepchild. This is true, Dimitri. Bianca told me this many times. And so Bianca has spent her whole life looking for love and looking for approval.
Well, Erica, come here, you, then you give her that. I mean, this situation with Bianca, it could be a temporary thing.
Yes, you know, yes, that's right. That's what I think too, Dimitri. I so agree with you. I think that this behavior of Bianca's is a call for help. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. You'll never know how much I appreciate your getting me to understand this, helping me. I could always turn to you in a crisis. I always could turn to you in a crisis. It would help me.
I like yours better, too. In fact, I had some good news. I finally heard from Alex.
Oh, really? Well, did she say why she ran off?
Well, there's no indication that that's what happened.
Well, where is she?
I don't know. The line went dead before I could find out. I got the distinct impression that she couldn't talk freely, that she might be in some sort of danger.
But that doesn't surprise you. I mean, given the number of shady characters in her background.
Yeah. But, you know, I just know that Alex can handle herself in most situations. That is the one thought that keeps me sane moment to moment. I guess I'm fated to fall in love with complicated women. You know, that's it, isn't it? All right, look, if you're okay, I've got to get headed home.
Well, we could have breakfast together.
I'd love to do that at another time. I just got so much stuff that I have to follow up on. Actually, Edmund and I suspect someone in town might know more about Alex's whereabouts than they're letting on to.
Oh, really? Anyone I know?
Well, it's better that you don't know.
Oh, I see, Will. I wish you luck. And thank you, then, for the use of your coat.
No, please. Coat, gloves, stay on you.
Dimitri, you're going to freeze.
Yeah, well, I won't. I won't freeze, and I'll pick that stuff up later.
Okay, then. That'll give me something to look forward to.
Erica, go home to Bianca. Be there for her. Can you do that?
I'll try.
Good. I'm going to walk you to your car, and I'm going to tell you something. If you ever go outside in this kind of weather without a coat again, you're going to hear from me. You hear that?